made it to the airport. Flight boards in 15 minutes. Had to stop by the new United lounge and check it out. Definitely an upgrade on the decor. Wish I had a little more time to explore. Next time. First flight of the year where the upgrade didn't go through. I was one seat away from being up front, back in the real world right now. But the sun is coming up and it's gonna make for an awesome sunrise as we take off, I think. I did at least manage to snag the exit row, which is cool, so it is definitely some leg room going on.
Thanks, see ya.
Probably shit, it's cold in New York. 37 degrees, I think. Trying to find a lounge, get some lunch.
Thank you, sir. Enjoy the lounge.
Not looking too optimistic for the connection tomorrow morning in Heathrow to get to Bergen. I gotta fly through Copenhagen. Awesome people here at the United Lounge really helped me out, booked me on a later flight. But this flight from Newark to London is over 2.5 hours delayed. I'm really looking forward to the new Polaris business class, but it is 2.5 hours delayed. So it's gonna be either a super tight connection in London tomorrow or crazy long day sitting at Heathrow Airport.
Eight different flights going on.
We do ourselves off.
Yeah, thank you.
It is cold in New York. I can't wait to get on this plane.
It's cold. 7-8. I
think there's more bedding on this flight than I have at home on my king size bed. This is crazy. So the flight is now over 3 hours late. And I really want to be optimistic, but I think 1 hour to process immigration, pick up my bags, and go recheck in and go through security in London is going to be too much. So we are looking at a long day in the lounge at Heathrow without my bags. Okay, flight is canceled. We are out of here. Everyone's getting off the plane. Everyone's getting off the plane. It's now 9 o'clock. We should have been halfway to London by now. Yeah, this is getting more and more interesting. It's all chaos. I think I might be just about the last person in Newark Airport. This has been quite the day. I was absolutely not planning on being outside the airport in New Jersey here. It's almost 11 o'clock at night and boy, it is cold. And now I gotta find a bus shuttle to the hotel. The insanity continues. It's like 11:25 p.m. right now. Haven't really been to sleep for 40 hours? I think we're going on 40 hours, something like that. And now I'm waiting for a shuttle to pick me up from the airport to take me to the hotel. The salubrious accommodations of the Wyndham Garden Newark Airport. These are the kind of hotels you stay in when you're like 19 or 20 years old doing your first van tour across America. So apparently it's never too late to stay in a Wyndham Garden. And what it will do is allow me to edit the vlog and get it up online, which I didn't think I was going to be able to do today. So there's always a silver lining. There's always a good thing to be taken on such a horrendous travel day. And this one might be number one right now in terms of horrendous travel days. Nope, false alarm, Renaissance, not Wyndham. I'm starting to think this shuttle bus is never coming. I've seen, I think, close to 30 buses go by. and not one of them says Wyndham.
Rooms on the fifth floor, elevators to your left.
Fifth floor.
Password to the Wi-Fi. Smile, you're all set.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Well, this is fairly civilized. Not the end of the world. It's warm. All right. What a day. 2 days. Just non-stop. No sleep. I'm a little crazy now. All right, this is the recap of all recaps. Let me run this down. What happened today? I thought today was going to be a really boring day. It was going to be getting on a plane, getting on another plane, and then that was going to be it. And I was thinking, wow, what am I going to put in a vlog today that involves just two flights? Well, let me tell you. I did get on the plane after no sleep in LA. Okay, fine. Made the flight. Get to New York. Flight is definitely delayed. Hour and a half. Okay, still no problem. Still going to make my connection in London when I get there. Then it's 2 hours. Then it's 2.5 hours. So they make a contingency plan, put me on a later flight out of London. So, okay, it just means I'm gonna spend a few more hours in the lounge in London, getting some work done, editing the vlog, writing some tunes, whatever it is. I thought, no problem. We get on the plane, we board the plane. Everything is good. Get handed the amenity kit. Everything is good. Then I get a text message saying, yep, the flight is canceled. The whole flight is boarded at this point. Everyone's on the plane, the doors are closed, the paperwork is in, we are leaving, and then it's canceled. Complete mayhem ensues, running around the airport. I do get a ticket on a later flight tonight and find out that having been in business class, I'm now in a middle seat in coach in like the back of the plane. So I have to make a choice. I have to ask myself, what do I want more? Do I want to take care of my body, and do I want to sleep and maintain my schedule and my health? Or do I want to really get beat up and sit in that middle seat and not sleep at all the way to London and arrive in Norway really jacked up? So I took the option to take a flight tomorrow. I'm now in a hotel. It took forever to get to, but I'm now in a hotel. I'm going to fly out tomorrow through Chicago. So I'm actually going west to go east. Then United tells me that because my onward flight from London to Bergen through Copenhagen was not on the same itinerary as my canceled flight from LA to London, they can't do anything for me in terms of the flights I'm missing. Real drag. That's a real drag. And because I bought this business class flight using miles, they can't put me on another airline because it's a mileage ticket. Now, I get it. Maybe that's their policy. Maybe there is a written rule somewhere that says if you buy a mileage ticket, regardless of class, and I bought a mileage ticket in business, they can't put you on another airline when they are at fault for your missed flight. But then you get to the bit where I've flown over 1 million miles with United. I've flown with them for over 15 years nonstop. I've maintained my 1K status that entire time. And you think somewhere, somebody must be able to do something. Unfortunately not. Unfortunately, the one ticket on a codeshare Star Alliance airline with SAS that they really could have got it, I had to buy it. So it was an extra $500 last minute. Totally sucks. But if there are no more delays, it means I am going to make the gig in Norway. We are going to record the live album and everything is going to be okay. And here is to packing protein bars in your hand luggage. I don't have any of my luggage right now. All of my luggage is sitting at Newark Airport. So if I wanted any of my clothes or any of that stuff or any of the food and stuff that I packed in there, not happening. Can't get that until I get to London. But I did pack a protein bar in my carry-on, which is huge, because this is just what I need right now. And what I need is to get some sleep, which I'm gonna do right now. And we are gonna be back and up and running tomorrow morning. Hopefully with no more delays, hopefully getting to London and then onto Bergen to play this concert. I don't know. I know as much as you do right now. So I'll check in with you tomorrow and we'll see what transpires.
Thank you.